good Thursday afternoon. Today's weather word, you guessed it, wind, guys. Let's take a look at the live conditions out here in the studio in Brockton. I don't even have the sound on, but you can just see the winds howling out there, gusting from 30 to 40. Pretty much mostly cloudy skies, but it's turning partly cloudy now as the sun's coming out. But you can see the wind just whipping around out there in our live view today. Very gusty, trash cans everywhere, everything blowing around anywhere. And for that, wind advisory has been issued until 8 p.m. by the National Weather Service. You can see it here. Northwest winds may reach 30 at times, gusting to more than 45. We've already seen this. Gusts will range between 46 and 57 miles an hour, capable of downing small limbs and branches. Has already done that as we go ahead in and take a look at our damage report. As someone just came into my chat after I said I was narrating, but let's go through this again here. Damage report, trees down, Norwood, 52 mile an hour wind gusts up here in Cape Ann, large limb down on Lynn Street, just lots of reports of damage. Poles and wires down out here in Northampton, well west of Worcester and western Massachusetts. We even have damage reports down here in Connecticut as well. But look at this amazing wind map, current wind maps here. Another one here in the northeast, pretty much two-thirds of the country is taken up by winds. Just amazing, amazing stuff, guys, with the winds. Two-thirds of the country taken up by winds. So, and they're gusting anywhere from 20 to 50 miles an hour. So amazing stuff. The reason being, still cold air. Still a cold pool air aloft head here with the 500 millibar vorticity plot here. And we move this forward, that bowling ball just comes through this evening. Still, you got tight isobars there. So the winds should persist into early tomorrow morning, gradually letting up towards the afternoon as that ridge builds to our west, which means warmer air as well for tomorrow. So approaching 70 in southwest southern New England, definitely a possibility. Then comes our next chance, severe weather outbreak entering Kentucky, Illinois, Ohio, Pennsylvania, and also maybe here in the Northeast. But we might have to wait till late Sunday to see a chance of pop-up storms here in the southern New England area. That would be late Sunday. Here's another graph of the current wind showing them blowing between 65 to 70 knots. So very windy out there today. You've seen... That's our weather word of the day. Plumes of wind for today, guys. And you can see it there in the model graphic lighting up as we move in towards Saturday. Wind shouldn't be that strong. So let's take you into the current southern New England conditions. You can see, again, in and out of the sun and clouds today. It's been this way for 3 days. It's been breezy for 3 days. On and off showers. We haven't seen that. I'm a little disappointed with that aspect of the forecast today. I thought we'd be seeing some pop-up showers here in eastern Mass. No reports of that as far as I know. Most of that has been confined to Maine, but look at the wind gusts approaching 30s, 40s, 50 miles an hour. Those should be diminishing here from this point on, but they're still going to be gusting up to 40, 30, 40 miles an hour throughout the night. There's a radar, everything basically confined to eastern New Hampshire and Maine, and it's drifting offshore as we take you in here. The clouds are on and off southern New England. Pretty much a pretty nice day. Lower 60s everywhere, as you can see. 56 in Worcester, 53 up in Cape Ann. Cool spot because of that north wind coming off. But you move just inland, and it's very nice out. Forecast on our surface map for tomorrow showing that warm front pushing north should be bringing the warmer air up, but that those thunderstorms developing tomorrow, and they could become quite severe across the mid part of the section. There you see the graphic with the 80s to ourselves, 70s approaching us, 60s in northern New England. You see that high pressure bringing that warm air right into southern New England. So a nice day for Friday, even hotter for Saturday, and Sundays will be in the 80s. Look at the setup for the severe weather, as we said this weekend. Ohio, Kentucky, Tennessee, same areas that got it last time, going to get it again, could be just as bad, I think, here. And we'll look at that on our model forecast before we end it for the day, guys. Staying dry here all the way through Sunday, it looks, and here comes that approaching severe weather outbreak, dropping 4 inches of rain easily in any storms that it produces. And we'll move forward towards Sunday. This is very early on Sunday. We could be getting into some convectivity here. about midday on Sunday, but it looks to come, another round looks to come in here late Sunday. That's it for today, guys. Visit me at www.anthonysneweather.ning.com for more updates. We'll talk to you later. Bye.